Have you ever seen one of these? What I'm holding in my hand is called a Bahtinov mask, and even if you've never had one on your telescope, I'm here to tell you that this is magic.
If you take your telescope out at night and you point it at anything in the sky, you can usually get perfect focus simply by turning the focuser knob while looking through the eyepiece. That's a no-brainer.
However, if you're using a digital SLR camera, or you're using the camera on a cell phone, or you're using a specialized telescope camera, well, then you're no longer getting a direct view through the telescope optics direct to your eyeball. That can make getting perfect focus a little bit tricky. You may get close, but again, you'll be limited to the resolution of your cell phone or the resolution of the screen on the laptop. And again, you'll get close, but it won't be as sharp as with the eyeball. So if you go back around, say, the turn of the century, this inability to focus became a bigger and bigger problem as digital photography took over the whole astrophotography realm. And back in 2005, an amateur astronomer named Pavel Bahtinov, this guy, came up with the idea of using light diffraction almost as a tool for telling whether or not you had achieved perfect focus. The end result of that, of course, was his Bahtinov mask. Now, it's been a while since I was in science class, but I'll give you a quick rundown on it. When light waves go through a grating, on the other side, they tend to coalesce either into brighter lines or not so bright lines. And in the case of the Bahtinov mask, you're going to end up with three different lines because you have three sets of parallel gratings. So let me demonstrate exactly how the Bahtinov mask works. The idea, of course, is that what if you had some visual sign that showed you exactly when you reached perfect focus, some unmistakable sign that you could see very clearly on your camera screen, no matter how low the display resolution is on the device that you're looking at. Well, that would be pretty helpful. So let's take a look at how this works. So let's say you're looking at a star, and it's always a star when you use the Bahtinov mask. And this, of course, is the circle of view that you're seeing through the eyepiece. This is what you're seeing displayed on your computer screen. Okay, so we've got it centered on a star, and we put the Bahtinov mask on. The first thing we're going to notice is we're going to see an X. This is basically two light diffraction lines that are crossing. Now, of course, there's actually going to be a third line, and let me use this paintbrush as the third line. As you turn the focusing knob on your eyepiece, on the focuser tube, you're going to see this line actually move left or right or left or right, depending on how you turn your focuser knob. And once it's right in the middle, right when it bisects the cross of lines, you'll know that it's in perfect focus. That means that you've achieved perfect focus for whatever the camera is on your digital device. So no matter where you point the telescope from that point on, you know it's going to be sharp. You move it over to the moon, you know the moon is going to be sharp. So this is exactly how the Bahtinov mask works. And after 2005, you didn't need to guess at your focus level anymore. Using Bahtinov's invention, you could get exact focus in like 20 seconds, really fast. So let me actually demonstrate on a real telescope. All right, so I'm going to demonstrate how to use a Bahtinov mask. I'm going to demonstrate it visually, although you would usually use the Bahtinov mask with some kind of digital photography or photography. Okay, so what you do is you find a bright star, not too bright. You don't want to use Sirius. Sirius would probably overwhelm the process, but find a bright star, point the telescope at it, get it centered in the view, and then, you know, attach your digital device to however you're going to be capturing it. Put the Bahtinov mask on the front. Now it can rotate. I guess technically it doesn't really matter, but I typically get this short axis aligned with the focuser tube. And then you look through the eyepiece and you adjust the focuser knob until you get that middle line crossing the diffraction X. All right, and from that point on, you know the telescope is perfectly focused for your particular setup. Pre-made Bahtinov masks are getting cheaper and cheaper. You can get them from $15 up to $50. It depends on the size that you want to get. And you can even get them made for your specific model of telescope. This particular one I printed at home on a Creality 3D printer. Now, Creality is not a sponsor of this channel. yet. Anyways, I printed this here, and it took 9 hours. The first attempt was, well, it didn't come out very well, but the second attempt came out, and here you can see it printing, and printing, and printing. And 9 hours later, this is the final product. And in all honesty, it came out great. You know, there's one last interesting note about the Bahtinov mask. Bahtinov never patented it. He felt that that would hamper scientific discussion. He also felt that the patent would be impossible to enforce. If you consider that you could probably trace this on a piece of cardboard and cut it out, well, then he was probably right. Please like and subscribe. Clear skies, everybody.